Vsauce, Kevin here with a game that gives you quantifiable, verifiable strength against your opponents, and even the advantage of going first. Simple math and logic conspire to delude you into believing that the odds are in your favor, but in the long run, I'm gonna win every time. And even when you understand how this paradox works, you still probably won't be able to rationalize it. It goes like this. I've got four different dice and I've replaced their regular sides of 1 through 6 with different combinations of numbers. Here are some maps to make it easier to see. A has 4s and 0s, B has all 3s, C has 2s and 6s, and D has 5s and 1s. You choose one and I'll choose one. We roll and the highest number wins. And because I'm so nice, I'm gonna let you choose the best die first. Which is the best? The simplest, safest way to choose the best one is to add up the sides and take the highest total. C has a total of 20. Those 2s aren't great, but the 6s beat anything. C seems like the best overall choice. B and D each add to 18, and A only has 16. But if you choose C, I'll choose B, and I'm gonna win most of the time. Look, here's a table of all the possible rolls both of us can have. Of the 36 possible combinations of rolls, B comes out on top 24 times to C's 12. You've chosen what looks like the best die, and I'll still beat you 2 out of 3 times. Okay, so just adding up the sides isn't good enough, so maybe you factor in standard deviation on the sides of the dice. Hold on. I'm gonna give you a game-changing hint. Here it is. A beats B, B beats C, and C beats D. These charts account for every single roll in that progression, and I'm showing you the data to prove that A is at the top of a chain of dominance. You know that due to the transitive property, if A beats B and B beats C, then A should also beat C. And if C beats D, then A and B should beat D too. It's like lining people up by height. If A is taller than B and B is taller than C, then A has to be taller than C. Makes sense, right? All right, let's play again. And it sounds like you want to choose A this time because, well, it beats everything. Because I literally just showed you that the transitive property makes A better than B, C, and D, right? Wrong. If you choose A, I'm gonna take the worst choice at the very end of the greater than chain. I'm choosing D to go against your A, and I'm going to crush you with my D. How? Okay, so here's why I'm choosing the worst die to beat your best. Wait, these dice are too easy. So many numbers repeat that it's elementary, and you're a genius. Let's use another set of numbers from 0 to 12. This set has the same property as the easier ones. A is better than B, B is better than C, and C is better than D. If we get a tie, we'll just roll again. You choose A, the strongest die. I want the weakest die because it's actually not. D is at the losing end of our chain, and my D die is still gonna win nearly 2/3 of the time against your strong A, which seems impossible, but let's test it. So despite D seeming to be the weakest and A being the strongest, out of 15 rolls, D won exactly twice as many times as A. D is somehow stronger than A. In this game, no matter what die you choose, I'm gonna beat you twice as often as you beat me, even with the A is greater than B is greater than C is greater than D chain of dominance. I'm always gonna pick a better die because these dice aren't transitive. These are Efren's dice. Here's the proof. My voice cracked. Who cares? Math! These charts reveal the truth about the matchups in our 0 through 12 dice, and I've labeled the squares that each die wins. Just like I said, A beats B around 2/3 of the time, and it's the same for B versus C and C versus D. But let's look at D versus A. Despite being worse against C, which is worse than B, which is worse than A, D is actually stronger than A, which makes no sense. It makes no sense, but it's mathematically true. Bradley Efron is a statistician who has won just about every award in the statistics game over the last 60 years, and he's still going. In 2018, he won the International Prize in Statistics, which is basically the Nobel Prize of Stats, and he invented what we now call Efron's dice. Sets of dice that are maddeningly non-transitive, and that non-transitivity is cloaked so carefully that it's almost impossible to grasp even when you know it's true. If you choose D, fine, I'll just choose C, which we know beats D most of the time. If you choose B, I can choose A and win a lot more than I lose. C, I choose B. A, I choose D. You literally have no way to win this game in the long term because I can always choose a die that's better than yours, even if you choose the best die first. And that's the veridical paradox here. How can you have the best possible choice that isn't? How can a die prove it's the strongest and then lose to the weakest? How can a die verifiably lose to everything except when it's up against the one that it shouldn't be able to win against? The problem isn't the dice. It's us. We fall into a cognitive trap of thinking in absolute terms when real value is often relative. In this game, the concept of better or worse is deceptive. It depends completely on the situation. Our brains, especially when it comes to numbers, want to sort patterns and construct algorithms and employ heuristics that identify the best choice. And we love ranking things, whether it's music or sports or serial tier lists. But life isn't always transitive. And if you get stuck thinking in absolutes, you're gonna get duped by the game master who knows when the real value lies in the relative. And they're gonna win most of the time. So unstick your brain, and as always, thanks for watching. I was gonna throw these at the camera, but that would be bad. So, there.